I brought the whole grocery store with me. It's gonna be a tough one. So don't fast forward the video. Watch this thing from beginning to end. Y'all might just be a little bit impressed. Manland, for once in his life, well, I might be able to teach you a little bit of something. Stick around. Amateur artist Mark D. Chandler. Let's get this puppy started.
Well, I'm Ranger Cookie. You know where I'm at, look like there. You know where I'm at. Manland is out here trying to cook everything on a stick. Breakfast bushcraft on a stick. And look at him. There he is working his ass off to make.
I'm tired already, y'all, and I ain't done nothing but get a stick.
I told you, making YouTube videos is hard work, or effing work.
Very hard work. Because you got to set the cameras up, you got to get your equipment, you got to get out here when there's plenty of daylight. And right now, we're running out of daylight.
You got one. About 3 hours left.
Don't take that much longer just to get the campfire going.
All right, let's stay tuned when he gets everything ready. I'll see you in a few seconds.
Let's see what happens. We're gonna do what you say not to do. We're going to sacrifice an egg, jumbo egg, at that. It'll make a big boom. Always heard. I know what happens in a microwave, but I always heard. An egg directly in the coal without poking holes in it and to keep stirring will cause it to go boom. I really want to shoot this on mine too.
Go ahead. Do a recap.
I'm gonna place the egg in there. Dang, that's hot.
Well, hurry up.
Man, I can't get in there fast enough. Let's see what happens. And this may not be far enough away. Grab my purple drink.
Grab mine too. It's
Where's your purple drink?
Right there at the leg. Watch, it's gonna explode!
Oh shit! I mean, damn it! Golly gee! Y'all, this is more fun than actually. Hey! What happened? My camera went off, you son of a bitch. I thought it was on record. It did it again. I don't think it recorded. Just in case, ladies and gentlemen, we just put a jumbo size egg.
And it does explode.
And wait, it just blew, didn't it?
Yep.
Well, I missed it.
Yep. No, it's many you got it on record, it exploded.
Well, that didn't take long.
No.
Well, it didn't go boom.
No, it just went.
That sucked. I got another egg. Let's do this again. Since it don't take that long. Hold on, take two. This is what happens when you shoot a YouTube video. We had it going the entire time. However, my camera was not actually on record. Therefore, I apologize for the technical difficulties of shooting a YouTube video. This is what happens to a YouTube creator when he's trying to make good, useful content right there on YouTube. It doesn't always work, and Ranger Cookie can attest to it. Sometimes shooting videos suck. However, this is one of those political public announcements here for the YouTube viewers. It's not my fault! We can actually get closer.
Yeah, that didn't explode like you thought it would be.
No, it wasn't no big boom at all.
Alright, Manland's ready to do take two.
That really sucked.
Part two of exploding egg into fire. Let's find out what happens. Don't do it! It's gonna blow!
But what happened? I mean, I didn't even see it. I didn't even hear it.
It just went like a fart.
What the egg?
Over here.
I can't waste too many eggs. I gotta cook one on the fire. My camera's running. There's another one. Maybe it had a little fracture in the egg, who knows. We shall place egg right against it. That's hot. It actually did not take very long. Gonna move the egg into the center of the camera. I'm gonna zoom in. Because that was not much of an explosion.
Well, it started at 1 minute on my clock. Let's see, 15 seconds so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, they say these eggs explode. The first one we did just went, that's it. Maybe it's because we got commercial eggs.
Yeah.
You know, a real farm fresh, free range egg has more explosive properties. Hey, Yankee Living, that's one for you to test out. Place an egg on the coals and let's see if that thing really goes boom, because I bought some store-bought eggs on this particular round. And the shell is already starting to turn brown. That was disappointing. You want to throw the can of Vienna sausages on there next? I cannot believe this. That was, you know what? Cookie.
Huh?
I think it already blew a hole out.
On that one?
Yes. Hell yeah. Come here, look.
Oh, man. Maybe when you dropped it, it cracked.
No, no.
Yeah.
No. Let me get my camera zoomed. So y'all see the egg yolk? It already went poof, and I don't know if it even caught on camera.
It didn't.
Oh, man.
It caught on this one about it.
I think so. That sucks.
I ran out of film on my little iPhone crappy thing.
So the myth about eggs going boom on a campfire.
All right, I'm Ranger Cookie, and this is Mark D. Chandler. I'm sorry, amateur Mark D. Chandler.
That's right.
And he's trying to cook on a stick. So we're going to watch him cook on a stick. The ingredients, hash browns, an egg, some coffee, and what else?
Let's see, we're going to cook an egg, bacon. I forgot. Egg, bacon, hash brown. Oh, now the smoke's in my eye. All right, egg, bacon, hash brown. Toast, grits, and some extra things on the side here. That's at the end of the video. And I would have my eyes wide open, but I'm sitting here in the smoke.
All right, well, sit back and enjoy. I think he's ready to start cooking. Are you ready to start cooking?
I'm ready to start cooking.
All right, well, we got the cameras on for you, sir.
As soon as I get my stick adjusted in the laboratory, here we have an egg, and we're going to poke a hole into the egg for safety reasons, okay? We just tried two eggs in the campfire. I caught one of them here. It wasn't that impressive. So it's not like a great big explosion. But we're going to crack a hole into the egg. We're going to do it on the side on this particular egg right here. And I think that's more than enough. I'll show you that it runs. Okay, we've got a little drippy egg. We're going to place this on the stick. It's on the board, okay. Now we're going to place said egg on the stick, and I think my stick is at the wrong end.
I do believe.
That's hot. Woohoo! That puppy's hot. So I know it's about the right distance. If you can keep your hand there 5 seconds or less, That is the proper cooking temperature when you're cooking anything on a campfire. So we're going to give that a go. I predict you're going to see the egg start to bubble and boil out of the hole. And in about 15 minutes or so, about that age, about the age of 15 minutes, we are going to see a perfectly cooked, boiled type of egg that's actually roasted on the campfire. That's a man-land guarantee. However, this is not what I want it to do. I'm going to let y'all know that right now. I had another technique because we're going to cook a whole bushcraft type of breakfast. And for that, I'm going to enlist the friend and help of Ranger Cookie. I'm turning mine off so I can edit this video.
And this is a background video how Manland does his work.
So it's behind the scenes.
It's behind the scenes of the Mark, the Avenger Mark D. Chandler. So should we watch him all the time and see what he does next?
By and by me, as you got to remember that there's a camera on and I don't need to cuss. Oh, it's like this.
Yes. Mini me.
Hey. Yeah, you're looking pretty daggone good. Let's check this right here out. Let's see here. Behind the scenes, right? Okay. 5 seconds. No, I can't even do it for 5 seconds. That's too hot.
I can feel it from here. Where are you coming from? My camera's hot because it's so close.
Yeah, tell you what, we're going to leave a jazz like that right there and see what happens. That's like what? That wasn't even 2 seconds. 1,000, 2,000.
Well, I tell you what. Hey, I tell you what. Let's do this.
That's hot.
Let's do it the correct way. That way we.
How you got a correct way?
Are you Mark?
Huh?
Are you Mark?
On your mark? Okay. Oh, you going
to
time it? To
say start. Now I'll push the button.
Okay. Start. 1,000, 2,000. Holy moly. Nope.
You seen how fast it was? Jesus. Let's try it again.
It needs to go up to 5 seconds. But you know what? It's going to burn down. It's going to reduce its heat. The wind's not blowing. That's a great factor. The wind's not blowing. So we're going to let it sit just as is. And you got to remember, wood, even though it burns, is actually an insulator. So a lot of that heat is not getting to that egg like you think it should be. I expect this stick, actual stick, to start burning. I actually do. We're going to see it start smoking. But as this thing here burns down, the egg has not even been discolored yet. I think we're actually in a good situation. I think this is going to work perfectly fine. I don't expect this egg to blow. None at all.
There, you put a hole in it.
Yeah. Because the two eggs we had on there, as far as the explosion, it
this went.
I mean,
it took a fart.
Yeah, it's exactly what it is. It just wasn't that impressive. So, Yankee Living, brother, if you happen to have some good farm fresh eggs, this is a shout out to you. Get a real chicken egg, put it in the coals of the fire. Let's see if the thing goes boom. Because from what I've seen here, it just ain't happening.
I think what happened in the microwave, the molecules are going much faster. So it's boiling that egg quicker.
Well, now, I will say this. When I did the microwave test, I was about the age of 16 or 17 years old. And back then, eggs were probably real eggs. Not this commercial stuff that they have now. Genetically engineered, so they're easy to peel. I don't know. Let's find out. That's just a man-made opinion there.
I hope they're not bringing more kids over here.
I do know we have to rebuild that fire a little bit for the coffee episode, because that's going to be critical.
Well, we got plenty of firewood right there, a big pile of it. We got power behind me.
We got enough daylight to catch everything. And I'm supposed to be doing the bacon and the egg and everything on there. But I wanted to actually shoot this video here first, just like we tested in the laboratory, and see how it turns out. I got my stir stick right here.
And the stir stick is where you go into the egg and see if you...
Just to make sure that the... Are you still on? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just to make sure that the, when the egg cooks, it seals the hole up where the egg itself is cooked, right? And that creates a pressure vessel. The pressure vessel. This is why I edit my videos. I don't talk very plain. I have a very bad habit of stuttering. And something y'all didn't know, by the way. Ask Ranger. He knows. I like to flub my words very flubbably.
He edits shitload of videos. Somebody walking his shadow, he's editing it.
Yeah, I do. Oh, cut!
Oh my God, we did a video together. It was the Ranger Cookie shout out for my giveaway. And a kid rode his bike in the shade. And you should see how pissed this man was. He was pissed.
I was having a fit, like, yeah, you kids go out there and lay down in the highway and count the mufflers as they go by.
He was pissed, I'm telling you. So this is a behind scenes of Manland. You can see this on my channel. I do have long videos, but I need to start. But this is just behind the scenes, just to show you how much work we got to do.
I don't mind long videos, I just don't like them on my channel.
Yeah, that's what this said.
So this is actually perfect, because Cookie doesn't mind putting up a long video and show the actual behind the scenes. We're not trying to trick you here. I'm not trying to trick anybody. This is how it is. This is the real life. And as long as we make it entertaining, hopefully you'll stick around and watch it. I don't mind that at all. But if, you know, I just don't like long videos. That's just me personally. I cut through the thick and thin, get right to the important part. There it is, bam.
Even Texas, Papa Texas, he says YouTubers have a mind a set of a peanut.
Yes, what a very short attention span. And I'm guilty. I'm the same way.
I mean, if the camera's not moving today's society, you don't want to watch them. The camera's moving all the time, especially the new TV camera. God. It's so like.
We might need to actually lower this now. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. Yeah, let's try to lower this a little bit.
Now, you might drop your egg. You might drop your egg.
Yeah, you might. You're right. I didn't get a stick with enough to cook in it.
Yep.
See what happened here. You break out.
How about pushing the cones up?
I didn't bring my gloves, man.
Look, I gave him a brand new pair of gloves. And didn't bring them.
Man,
it came off already.
Only on Manland.
Hey, you just wash it off. It's probably cooked already.
No, it ain't cooked already. I'm gonna set it right there.
Yep, it's oozing some blood.
We'll pick it.
Yeah.
I got the thing for my stick. Yeah. Now. Hey man, what happened? It was balanced a while ago.
Yeah. Stuck it in the ground too, probably. See, that's it. See how long it takes him to figure out. And imagine you watching a whole video of him doing this, and it would probably be boring because he's not going to talk through the whole video, but he might talk through the whole video and say a little bit about certain such such. But if you edit and cut your videos, you don't have to talk through the whole thing.
That mother is hot. I gotta wash my egg off, man.
I hope so.
Yeah. You're going to eat it, not me.
I'm always a guinea pig.
I'm eating the next egg.
Oh, you going to wait till I get the dirty one, huh?
That's right, I'm giving you the dirty one.
Well, you're cleaning it, so.
Well, we're not going to eat the shell.
No, we're not going to eat the shell.
It was cracked. It was getting hot. Okay. Ow! Hot. Ow! Really hot. I grabbed the wrong damn stick. Ain't quite got the fork. Now the stick's acting like an insulator.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Should make a basket. Like
I'm
I was.
Make the next actual egg cookie is what I actually envision, which is going to be a bacon basket that will actually hold the egg itself. So it's going to be bacon and egg suspended by a stick. Should be perfecto. We'll find out. It worked in the oven in my laboratory. Well, it almost worked. It actually didn't work. The container I was using was acting like an insulator and didn't quite cook the bottom of the bacon. It was still raw. The top was like burning. The bottom of it, inside the can, raw.
All right, we're going to take a short break and see what happens. Here's a blooper for you. When you are cooking stuff and your egg falls into the fire, that's a blooper.
Roll it out and grab some water.
So basically it was just sitting there and all of a sudden it went boop, into the...
Make sure you got a stick that cradles the egg properly.
That might help.
But anyway, we know that's hot. Son of a bitch!
Egg five?
Quick,
it might cook faster down there.
Cracked it.
Aw.
Yeah, hell with it. We just sacrificed that egg.
So, making a video might take...
Dropping the egg down.
Might take longer than you think.
Yeah, dropping the egg down when you didn't have the proper angle. Not exactly cool. Take two.
Take two.
Break off.
So cooking on a stick is probably more in a bargain than you thought.
For those of you just tuning in, because I didn't turn my camera on, go and watch Ranger Cookies channel for the evidence of the stick, the egg falling off the stick and landing in the fire.
Twice!
We're going to do, several times. So we're going to sacrifice yet another egg and start this process back over. Well, before I do that...
You should put some fire on.
I'm going to actually raise the stick because the fork of the stick is not at the right angle. That's why it keeps falling off. And the smoke is in my eyes as usual. Now I can't see. Okay. This ground is hard as Hades out here, I'm telling you.
Just imagine if he recorded the video from beginning to end and all the bloopers and all the flaws and all the extra work we have to do to make a video just for you to enjoy and laugh your ass off.
I'm using my knife as a wedge. For some reason, the stick worked perfectly. Now it's way too wobbly. I don't get it. There's my pocket stick. Here's my new egg.
Again.
Still wants to go forward. Still wants to lean.
Yeah.
Not supposed to do this. Yep. Gonna fix that. Well, that was simple. where's the stick? Okay. Get the egg balanced, which is, oh man, I forgot. That's what this extra stick was there for. That's hot.
To hold the egg.
We like the egg. The egg that the holds it.
Why did you put some paracord there?
Well, no, we can't use paracord.
Yeah, I know. The rules was one stick.
One stick. Let's get
stick. Now, he has to make another stick. Just think about all the work he puts into this video. This did give you a 10-minute video.
Yep.
And mostly the time, we don't talk through the video when we cut it off. We just fix the problem and keep going. But since he has a viewer here watching him, you know, commentary him, he will talk. And since I have the camera on, he's telling you what he's doing, so you won't be like, what are you doing? He's telling you. How about a machete? Come on, you got it. So now he has to find another stick. Is it a jalapeno on the stick?
Not yet, but it's fixing to be.
A jalapeno on the stick. All right, he got a new stick. Now he has to carve it. He did this earlier. I didn't have the camera on, but now you get to see from the beginning to end.
The idea here is you don't have to have a fancy stick, but you need a stick that has at least three prongs. At least three.
How about, see if you can cook some hash browns while you're waiting or trying
to... Well, you know, that would be nice. We could do that evidently, but let me reposition the stick. Is I'm under pressure. I'm trying to beat the sunlight. We got a late start shooting the video.
This sun, look, it's almost an hour. Looks like 2 hours left.
We want to cradle the stick. And I really didn't think this ground would be this hard.
It's only 3:20.
And it gets dark about 4:15, 4:30. I didn't set up my wedge on the end.
Now you got too short of a stick.
Yeah, where's mine? It's not too short because
you want it away from the flame.
I need a weight.
How about a stick? A stick.
Something tiny, heavy.
There you go. A stick.
That'll work. I'm gonna balance this stuff.
How about two more sticks? See. Yeah. What's improvised? Let's put a stick in front and a stick in the back.
Sound like a wiener.
Now
there we go. Voila. And then the weighted stick on the very end. That's how you do it. Oh, too much. Now let's get the angle on this. While it's not hot, see how she balances this.
Now it might take longer now since it's away from the.
No, we're gonna fix that.
Oh, that's right. You can always drag the coals to the fire.
There it is right there. Now it's balanced just right. I mean, it's balanced.
Part take two.
Am I recording?
I don't know. You've turned it off.
Yep, I was recording. Damn. Now we got to sit there and shove. Now I need a big stick. Let's take the stick. And move our coals and flop it over eggs. Oh no!
Once again, the egg drop.
I ain't got that many eggs.
I don't know. I think just the movement of the dirt. I don't know. You got me. We have to do an instant replay on that one. It's dripping everywhere.
It sure the hell is.
You got the hole right or
the
crack?
Heck with this damn technique. Which it will work. Not here on video. Let's go, because I'm running out of daylight. Let's do it the way I plan to do it. Be done with this bullshit. Let's get some coal around that puppy, along with these eggs.
Here's a note. I go home and I be taking a shower. And I be thinking about what we're going on, what I'm going to do that day. And it's all in my mind, all in my head. I'm going to do just like this. And guess what? The same thing he's having happens to me. You think it, but really actually doing what you thought? Yeah, what's in your head? Oh, yeah, I can just take that stick and put it there, put that egg right there and be done with. But nope, when you do it, this is like his second egg or third egg?
It's gonna be my third egg.
His third egg that he lost during the process of cooking on a steak. Why don't you just bring a frying pan and cook on a frying pan? It might be better. Yeah, but you see, you're killing yourself.
Everybody's got a frying pan.
Yeah, but the question is, you're losing most of your food. You'll be starving to death.
It's called practice and technique. Once you learn how to do it, then it's very, very simple. And I just knocked my log. Here's some bacon.
All right. I think the bacon would be the best what thing. This is the Dolly Parton anyway. And smoked. As long as you're not using pond, I heard.
Actually, I'm doing it all wrong. Crap. Yep. I did not prepare fast enough. I got to prepare.
Preparing is a must sometimes. Are you recording over here for a reason? You want me to stop this?
Yeah, stop.
Save some juice.
Yeah.
See, that's time. Recording, you forget to turn it off. You lose a lot of your recording. You have to go back and get another battery or something like that. It takes practice in getting stuff ready for a video. That's too close.
Way too close.
You broke your stick.
No.
A perfect stick you heard it had earlier. It's broken now. Now he has to find a new stick. You need my machete this time, so you. I love my machete, but this little hook thing.
The hook thing may actually come in handy.
No. It's kind of dull. I sharpen it, but I mean, see how sharp that was?
Three times, a lot better.
It's pretty sharp. He might go through all three of them.
Don't want to do that. Okay. Now. Almost broke that in half. I need that right there in case I need to lower it. Just in case. Got all? See if that's any better than this stick right here.
Maybe you should plan multiple sticks in multiple places so you can probably cook multiple food at the same time. And
yep, but that's the idea. Get out here ahead of time, get prepared.
Yeah.
Be prepared. Running out here and within 30 minutes thinking you're going to get this done is a total bullshit idea.
Yeah, in your mind, oh yeah, it's going to take 10 minutes. Shit, try about 2 hours. We got out here at what, 2 o'clock?
That's right.
It's made to hold the stick up this amount. Right. Yes, right. Throw it in the fire, burn it.
That's a little bit better.
Where's your fork?
I'm sitting there looking and thinking. I didn't actually plan.
Alright. I don't want to see if I can do any better. So let's find out if Ranger Cookie could do a little better than Mark D. Chandler. Amateur. We both amateur. So let's see what I can come up with since I'm out here doing nothing waiting on him. So I shall be back. Yeah. One egg, please.
Right there.
So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take an egg, and I'm going to go out and find me a stick that can hold my egg. That'd be probably the best thing. I don't know. Let's find out. And I'll be back with my stick that can hold my egg. Look, a rabbit!
Really? Let's eat it.
All right, Manland's egg looks like it's cooked all the way through, so he's going to pull it out the flames.
I would.
Maybe you need to get some pinchers.
We need some pincher tongs. Let's get this.
Yeah, that sucker looks cooked.
It's still kind of runny looking.
Shake it.
There we go. I'm going to set this puppy to the side and let her cool down before I even try to peel it.
Oh yeah, that thing will burn your fingers.
Burn your fingers and your toes. Now, let's get some flames going.
I'm blowing away on this. All right, we'll be right back.
And the bacon are now on fire.
They might cook better, I don't know.
No one's going to rescue it.
No, hell no. I might have to move the, oh, damn, my aim fell.
It fell. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Hey, but I bet you that sucker is doing. Let's pull it out.
I bet it ain't. The bacon wasn't even cooked.
Nope, it's not done. So, I guess the flames burnt my basket. Damn you, boy. But maybe if I made my basket a little bit more and the flames didn't get to it, it made it uncurl, I'll bet you it'll work. But I had to start a flame. But at least, hey, the bacon's getting cooked.
Is it halfway done?
Well, one piece is. All that.
Oh, yeah.
No!
It fell into the fire?
Don't worry, I saved it.
I missed that.
Ah, bitch. No! Oh, it's on top. No, no.
Ah, well, sacrifice that thing. No, the bacon over here is on fire. Save it. Save it. Rescue that. Rescue it.
Give me another piece of
twig. Wait, wait, where's my neck knife? Where's my neck knife? Here it is. Oh, no, it went into the fire.
We can probably save it. Yeah, we saved
it. He shot across the damn yard.
I saved it.
Quick. Let's see. Leave that back. We're going. Hey, there's two strips of bacon left. We'll leave it right there. Throw your egg into the coals. Maybe we'll have two eggs to eat and some bacon. Damn, that's like burnt and raw. That's pathetic. Cookie gonna try to salvage that piece of bacon.
Hey, it's still good, and nothing wrong with that piece of bacon.
Oh no, now that bacon's on fire. Crap, this, what's going on here?
Maybe you push the flames away. Don't touch the stick.
I got that guy.
No, we can move the coals.
Get a stick, get a stick.
We'll move the coals.
Yeah, move the coals, move the coals. Save the bacon, man.
But at least get something out of this deal.
The hell with the egg. Save the bacon. Let them burn.
Oh, no.
Now.
We saved the bacon.
Woo. Feel a lot better now. Lord have mercy.
Hey, at least we got bacon out the deal.
Well, I got an egg. I don't know about you. Where's your egg?
I have to push it in the flames.
Put it in the coal.
Give me a stick. There you go.
Here, Cookie is attempting to push his egg into the coals. You say that bitch is hot. Now remember, the purpose of this video is to show you and y'all's the stuff you see on YouTube. It may not necessarily be true or work as easily as they portray it to be.
And I got the back scenes of the back of the scenes of Man Lands making his
ultimate failure.
Failure.
My egg is actually done. It's going to be actually edible. Didn't crack the egg or nothing, did it?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, you got to get that dude up in the cold, man. It ain't gonna take much longer and it will actually be cooked.
So, another note. Don't think making YouTube's videos are easy. They're not. Right now we got gnats flying around.
Gnats are flying everywhere out here. The coals are supposed to be.
Then, we got... We're doing something we never did before. That's gonna be a failure and
well, an actual failure, but a success in learnings.
Correct.
Don't rely on the knowledge you see on YouTube. When you watch that YouTube video and they show you how it works, it may have actually worked then. But remember, knowledge is not experience. Man, them gnats are everywhere.
Yeah, I know, they're really bad.
Yeah. You gotta get out there and practice it yourself. Guarantee you, me and Cookie are eventually gonna get this thing to work.
It might take us 100 tries, but we're gonna get it right. And we're gonna show you the right one.
Yeah, we're definitely show the right one. But we're gonna be honest about what we do.
I'm a pretender. Remember that.
Man, look at the gazillion of gnats right here.
I know.
Goodness gracious. Why they love smoke? That's another damn myth that's busted. Build a campfire. Make the bugs go away. That's bullshit.
I know wearing a hat keeps them off your face for some reason.
Yeah, well, they don't like come under there and get in your eyes or something, but...
Yeah, I heard that from Grumpy. Some of you wear a hat, the mosquitoes won't come underneath there.
I don't know right now, man. It's just like it don't make no sense. Okay, I'm going to pretty much end the video right here. Total absolute failure, but a 100% success and learning experience. First of all, don't come out here and expect to be able to do this right off the bat. We're under the pressure. What? How many hours we have?
Two, three. We came out here on 2:20.
Yeah, we were like fighting daylight time. Did not have anything set up right. Here's my egg. The lighting is very, very bad. This looks gnarly, man. Show Cookie's camera. This thing looks horrible. Now, I know that this egg is cooked all the way through, so there's not going to be any problem eating it. The bacon, what's left of the bacon? Well, it's halfway raw, halfway burnt. Preparation is the key. Now, I'm gonna try to crack this egg. It's still a little bit warm. Is that raw? I can't tell, man. It's all, God, it looks bad. It looks horrible, man. So Papa Texas, right at the moment, man, brother, you got it going on. Manland said he can do this. Don't worry, it's Manland. You know I can do this. And yes, I can. However, not at this moment. I've got gnats, gazillions of them flying around my head.
They're in the smoke. They love that smoke for some reason.
And that's another myth, and I didn't say this on my camera. The myth about building a fire to keep insects away, that's bullshit. We
yeah,
got
look
like
at
a gazillion. I mean, they're everywhere, all over my face.
Look at my camera. Look at them. They're playing in the smoke right there.
Those are the smoke gnats. They love that smoke, and I think that's what attracted them here. Oh, I'm out of frame. I'm sorry, y'all. We got a little bit of a char there, like we did in the experiment there in the laboratory. A little char on the bottom of the egg. But this egg actually peels better than what we did in the oven. Now, let's get rid of that, too. I mean, this looks awful, man.
Look at the holes in that thing.
If this is survival cooking, you know, and you're supposed to be surviving, well, half your damn egg is now gone. Because it's attached to the, half of it fell in the fire, the other half, you know, you peeled away. This is awful.
That's why I say, I mean, why you should just get a pan.
I know, but the whole challenge is to do an egg on a stick. That's the whole challenge. Now, I'm sure it can be done, y'all. I'm sure it can be done. Now, let's take a look at the center. And it's actually cooked all the way through. A little bit soft on the inside. Showing Cookie's camera here at the same. Oh, and I just dropped half the damn yolk. Which part you want?
The
white. Your egg.
I put it over there to cool off.
Cool off. We're gonna try his egg and mine. Which one you want? The mostly white. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you try it around here. You gotta get it right here to the camera. Now, taste
it.
Taste it.
Tastes like a
boiled egg. It's actually a success. However.
You just could have put the damn thing in the colds.
That's what I've been seeing on YouTube. Cooking it on a stick is difficult. Not impossible. Just very damn difficult.
Maybe if you weave a basket around the thing, then put it in the fire. Maybe.
You want to try the bacon then? Does that still look raw?
Yeah, it's still raw. I try to put some fire underneath it. I hope we don't die of smoke in your house.
My suggestion is to bring actual cooking implements out here, like a fry pan or a grill or
it
something
might help.
Like that. And yeah, oh, it might help. I think it would actually do the trick. I actually brought mine out here.
Let's see my egg.
Let's check his egg out. He started on the stick in the basket, and the basket burned through.
A little white.
Uh-oh. It's still hot. Well, put it in some water, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, got a bit of water. His egg's a little bit dirty. Let's give it a bath.
Come on.
Actually, yours looks better than mine.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, get that good cold water. Cold water on there. Yeah. Yeah.
Let's see if I can peel mine.
Okay.
The object is to do this with your egg before you start.
I don't know if you want to do that with that egg.
Now, after you roll your egg, you should be able to peel it.
Yeah, half the egg's coming away with the shuck.
Shut up.
I know we're supposed to be professionals here. Hey, I never said I was a professional.
That's right. I'd never say I'm professional.
Man, what did I? Look at that big old. Show that. Show that. Look at the gap in that egg. Get up close to the lens. Look at that getting to turn it just a little bit. Get the damn yellow jacket out of here.
He's hungry.
Look at that, man. Now, that's gnarly looking, man. Cooking egg on the campfire without your skillet. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's the best thing ever.
I've seen all these videos.
How about go buy you a damn frying pan? If you can buy a damn egg, you buy a freaking frying pan.
That's what I say.
I go to these flea markets, and $2, I can buy a whole set.
For how much?
$2.
$2.
$2, amigo.
$2, you could just save your egg.
Yeah, save your egg.
You have all your egg. When you put it in your mouth, you have your egg on top, and you eat your egg. I mean, like half your egg's gone from cooking. The other half is gone from peeling.
Well, I still got a round spot.
It's kind of roundish. All right, break it in half, up close. Let's see what happens. It's actually cooked all the way through, y'all. No doubt about it.
Mm-hmm. Pick the one you want.
I'm going to try this in here.
You want the yolk on this one?
Yeah, it don't matter. You don't like yolk?
Nah, not really.
I'll take yolk, man. Shoot you. I'm a yolker.
That's good. We could have had rabbit stew a while ago.
Oh yeah, man, we had a rabbit come out here a while ago. That was
If I had my bow, I could have peeled better.
I have to admit, the thing tastes pretty good. I got salt and pepper, and we didn't do it here, but
good.
That's pretty good. Just like half the egg.
We need to get the bacon off the fire.
Ah, the hell with the bacon. I think it's halfway burnt, halfway raw. Show that. Let me show this right here, right quick. Look at most of the egg. It's now here on the ground. Can y'all see that? I hope you can. That's pathetic. Absolutely pathetic.
All right, now.
Here's the bacon. Oh, you pulled it off?
I pulled one piece off, piece that was.
Zoom back. There we go. That actually looks pretty good. Let's try that. That's not bad. Oh, wait, I got to.
Where's my back?
Let's get back. The smoke's bothering us, but not the damn bugs.
Come here. Wait. Come down. Look at us.
Now, all right, take 2, 3, 4.
Wait. All right.
The bugs are bothering the heck out of me. Now, the actual bacon, hey, not too bad. A little charred, a little smoked it, and not bad at all. I mean, really good. Hey.
Hey, that's good.
Hey. I'm kind of impressed with that.
I know. You still got ring cook.
Got another piece on there. We're going to finish cooking. Oh, it's got a real good smoky flavor. Oh. And the gnats here love it. My goodness.
Yeah, when the smoke went into the camera view.
These gnats love the smoke, man. They're just like hovering in the smoke.
Damn, they're just attacking me like bees.
I don't get it. But anyway, that's it for now, y'all. I'm gonna let you right now. I said whether a success or a failure, I ain't gonna say it's a total failure, but it's a 99.999999% failure. Huh. And
that 1% was good.
Yeah, we're gonna try this again. We're gonna get a little bit more daylight, set everything up right. We're not going to cheat. We're not going to lie to you. That's the whole idea of this video.
And that behind the scenes on my camera, and he's going to delete and cut all kinds of crap.
I cut it out for time. I cut it off, not to
I know.
Slew anybody for time effort.
Yeah, because YouTubers got mind of a peanut, like Texas.
I got a mind of a peanut myself. You know, I don't watch long videos unless the video's super entertaining.
Yeah.
And y'all,
I apologize. That's hard
for that.
To do.
But
some of us can do it.
Here's the thing. Cooking an egg on a stick, it can be done. However, it's kind of like a ferro rod, flint and steel versus a Bic lighter. If you got a Bic lighter and you need to start a fire,
Bic lighter.
Use your Bic.
Yeah.
Okay. That's real life, okay? We're not trying to make anything up here. Cooking an egg on a stick, it can be done. However, I was halfway successful. Most of it cooked while on the stick. The other half cooked when it was in the cold, when it fell off.
Hey, I probably just put it came with the best part taste.
Yeah, it's I don't know, that was actually very good. And that little piece of bacon I just had.
It had
we got more char on it than I do actually bacon. So we got a little piece of raw bacon over here. We're gonna try that right now.
All right.
While we got some daylight, I'm gonna show you this big piece right here, which is hot as a Hades. It's still kind of raw and chewy.
That's his part.
I don't mind that. The yellow jacket evidently loves it too.
Fly off.
Yeah. But anyway,
you know, believe it or not, these yellow jackets are meat eaters.
Well, right now,
I'm gonna meet the.
Yeah, he's gonna meet some meat. It's actually very tasty. Yeah. Not something that I would serve to my guests.
No.
So I'm glad you helped to cook.
I hope we're eating later, because this is not going to be a good meal. No.
Man, we need some barbecue sauce. We need a hamburger.
A hamburger on a stick. Next.
I'm going to go ahead and cook all the bacon. Because the damn yellow jackets and everything else are all over the bacon. As long as these gnats are in there too, I don't know where they come from.
You keep your hat on, the gnats won't bother you as much in your face.
They sure be bothering me now. What they doing? And the egg don't fall off again because it looks like it's wanting to lean that way. What I had in mind. But I didn't take my time to put the process quick. That's what I wanted to point out on my video.
You got a fork over there?
Oh, I got a spoon.
No,
Yeah, this thing, that's the wrong one right here.
All right, here's my method I came up with. Let's see what happens. I hope I don't hit the stick.
We don't need to hit the stick.
Hit the stick.
We got one egg left.
Come down, look at me! Alright, here's my method. It was called a basket. It's on a stick. So, let's see what happens.
Oh no!
I didn't touch it.
My dang egg dropped off again. I about done had it with this egg on a stick deal. Alright, let's cook the egg.
In the basket!
Egg in the coals.
How about we cook?
I know that works.
The egg in the basket.
We'll go with the eggs and the coal technique.
There you go. Oh,
Cookie's got his, actually.
Give me your knife.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let me grab my knife. Hold on. Where is my knife?
Oh, shit. On the table.
Oh.
I forgot to poke a hole in my...
my neck knife.
My egg. Alright. Now, we're going to try the egg in a basket. That's hot.
Yes. That's something I didn't anticipate on.
All right. Well, we're going to try the egg in the basket. It might fall out because it. I didn't think about having it roll over and all that good stuff.
Well, I kind of give up on the idea because we're running out of daylight here. Don't fear. I will shoot the video egg on a stick. However, Ranger Cookie has come up with the idea of egg on a stick in a basket. What you're seeing at the top of the screen there is Ranger Cookie's egg on a stick, wrapped with a little piece of vine, type of vine, bacon draped over the stick, and my egg you see in the coals of the campfire. That's where it fell. That's where it's staying. I'm going to cook it in the actual coals. Here's the problem that I've seen so far. Did not get out here early enough to get anything prepared like it's supposed to be. So I will get that video shot. I guarantee you I can cook an egg on a stick along with everything else. Supposed to cook a lot of things else like the grits and everything. Y'all, this is going to be pushed back just a little bit. We're running out of daylight. We just want to get the eggs and the bacon cooked right now. They say it can be done. I said it can be done. We're going to find out. So here's the update thus far.
Ranger Cookie in his basket and Manland's egg ready to explode.
My egg is starting to boil like it's supposed to. So it's actually getting heat now.
And the Ranger Cookie's egg in the basket, it might fall the minute I touch the damn thing, but it's there.
But at least the bacon ought to cook.
Yeah.
Well, so we're going to have bacon and eggs. I think my damn egg's actually on fire. I didn't want an actual fire on my egg. Oh, it's next to that damn egg. I wonder. Damn you, eggs.
I thought about an egg on a stick. I'm like, he has to make a basket. If you don't make a basket, it's gonna fall out. It'll fall. That's the Ranger.
Oh.
I got a big old bag over there. We'll probably have more fun making the Ranger video.
Probably have fun doing this.
Yeah, I know.
Learning experience. I can get it done. It's just like.
No. You gotta make a basket. There's no way you can put an egg.
Actually, an
egg. Leave it.
Yeah, an egg inside the bacon.
Yeah, that might work.
It would work, but I gotta get in here and cut the sticks and get everything ready to go and make sure it's all set up right before I can start the fire. I ain't had no time to do this. I knew it was gonna run out of daylight. Always happens. That little run to fall screwed me up.
Waited for her to leave for unknown reasons.
Well, I know why. I'm supposed to let her leave. But I always do.
Oh, okay. She don't want to leave kind of a person?
She always bitches about her having to work. had 3 whole days off in a row. Now she's got to work the next 7 days in a row, which I understand is a long span. And her brother came down from Ohio. I understand that. But you got to understand, Cookie, every day she goes to work, she calls me and complains about having to work. Constantly. I don't bring my work home. When I'm off, or I get home at night and I got to go back to work, I don't talk about work.
No, the minute I get home, I don't talk about work.
I just don't care.
You hear me talk about fucking donuts and the bitches there and the assholes? No, I fucking come here to talk Ranger Kooky, Relam Lam, whatever. And
just enjoy life when you got it.
Yeah.
Don't sit there and talk about your damn job. I wish I had no job. I can't stand my job. Been there 17 years. I don't give a fuck. Leave. Get another damn job.
Damn, we need to do a little editing here. Stay tuned.
Not anytime soon.
You want this?
Why not?
He's gonna eat the fatty part. I can't eat the fatty part. Mm. It looks good, but thing's full of grease. What is that? Oh, let's do a shout out.
Paul and Reed.
Paul and Reed.
Well, I'm a mouth full of begging. The one channel that inspired this. too much bacon grease. The one that started this was Farrell Woodcraft. He showed how to cook an egg in the coals, outside the coals.
On a side.
On a stick. On a stick. And, hey, brother.
You did a good job. I didn't see your video, y'all. I'm going to go look at it.
It's a very good video. Y'all need to check that out. Predominantly, the people I'm giving a shout out here is this video related. It's going to be a video directly related to cooking the egg on a stick or in the campfire type of video. So to Farrell Woodcraft, you're going to get a shout out because you actually did it. You did it very successfully. I think your method worked fine. To Joseph Russell. I have to keep looking at my notes. Joseph Russell shot a breakfast kebab deal where he put sausage on a stick, amongst some other things. I'm not going to ruin that video for you. I want you to go check that video out yourself.
The sausage be really easy on a stick.
I don't know. I thought this was going to be easy.
No, not that one. I hope not.
I want to give a special thanks and shout out to Papa Texas, because Papa Texas actually took upon this challenge, and he cooked bacon and scrambled eggs on a stick. He did it differently than what we were trying to do, but his video is very much a success, because Papa Texas, that fella knows how to use that grill, I guarantee you.
Or is it Popper Kitchen?
That's Popper. It's Papa Texas.
Yeah, but when he's doing cooking, we'd be...
And then he says Papa... he says, hey, folks, Papa Texas and Papa's Kitchen. That's right. Oh, it didn't show my arm. Sorry. Oh. But Papa Texas. That's right. He knows his grilling techniques.
Yep. So Papa.
To Carolina Chris Outdoors. Chris, man, I'm sorry, man. We didn't get to the grits. I tried this out at the house. It works very, very well. Brought the stuff out here, but we're running out of daylight. We're going to have to save that video for another video. One of those success videos.
We got an hour.
To Central Oregon Survival Network. Hash browns. Brother, went and bought the hash browns. We didn't even get to that stage. We didn't get to the stage of the grits. We couldn't get past the eggs and the bacon. To Helga's Pennsylvania Cooking. Pancakes on a stick. That would have been the easiest thing.
We should have started
we
that first.
We should have had that one. We've got pancakes.
I even said,
once
you start our
stick.
Oh, we're going to do these eggs.
We could have done that.
To
Doug Dunnigan, adding the hot sauce. Yeah, well, self-explanatory. Got the hot sauce. Didn't even get to the stage that we could even use it. And to Calvin's Corner, putting an egg in a microwave. Oh, yeah. I might actually do that tonight just because I need an explosion.
You know, if you peel all the shell off and put the little yolky thing in, it still explodes. Well, you don't believe me? Try it. You're going to fail.
I think I got one egg left. I think we're going to put that on the microwave and watch it go boom.
You.
Because the egg on the campfire, man, that was
disappointing. Like I said, I think it was the stuff in the microwave cooks it faster and it makes it bubbly, and it explodes. But when you cook it on the fire, it takes longer. Maybe if it was a flame, a hot, hot flame, and you threw it in there, well, not throw it in there, set it in there with your hand, it might...
Well, all I know is from the eggs blowing up to the actual campfire cooking that we were doing here, everything was very, very disappointing. But we had a lot of fun because my bud, Ragey Cookie, showed up. We like trying things out there we never tried before. We're going to get this thing. Hey, if you want to see a real video, go back and check some of my older videos and some of our newer videos when it comes to actually cooking on a campfire.
Yeah, you go check out his cooking the egg and orange peel.
No, it wasn't me. That was Firestarter. Firestarter actually did that. I'll put that link in there for you too. Watch cooking an egg. No, that was in my list.
Oh.
My actually egg and bacon, I think it was, the egg and bacon challenge, to where he put an egg inside an orange peeling with some bacon. And it turned out pretty dead gum good. Mm. Ooh, I can taste that now. Matter of fact, I think I'll try that next. Not tonight,
I'm gonna give it a shot. How about some horse meat?
Ooh, horse meat.
Yeah. Very salty. Hey, that's really a survival thing. If you need horse meat, just cut your piece off.
Is he alive?
Well,
that would hurt.
I know, poor horsey.
Well, anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to cut this in short. This is amateur artist Martin D. Channer, along with...
Ranger Cookie!
Wishing you and y'all a very happy YouTube experience out there. And remember this, don't believe everything you see on YouTube. It may not be the truth. Hey, but you know what? Knowledge is one thing, but actual skills
is another.
A whole different ball game.
So don't forget to eat it every day.
Right, get out and practice. And you gotta eat what you practice. That wasn't so bad. I mean, it was actually pretty decent. It wasn't that great. It was the kind of stuff I sweep under the rug and throw in the
trash. You know, I could have just grabbed my frying pan out my vest and had a dinner for two.
I had my improvised frying pan right over there.
Oh.
Hey. Y'all take them easy. Bye-bye now.
Bye. Even just videos are too long already. Well, we'll touch them, but...